Hello, I'm Dr. Manveer Bhatia, a senior neurologist and a sleep specialist. I've been seeing a lot of patients with sleep issues in these recent times, and particularly teenagers. So I thought I would discuss a case and also discuss what is the best approach and how one should deal with these patients. So this is a patient who is 19 years old and who came to me with the main problem being poor sleep. So whenever we see somebody with this poor sleep issues, we need to go and understand a lot more. That how long has this problem been for? So which the answer was that it was there for a few months. For the last few weeks, it has been aggravated considerably. And so what is the problem? Is the problem in falling asleep? Is there a problem in maintaining sleep? Or does one wake up too early? Or is there something called as non-restorative sleep? So he answered these questions in this following way, that he has a difficulty in falling asleep. Maybe how often is this is the next question that we ask. So he says it's about 3 to 4 times in a week that it takes almost an hour or 2 hours to fall asleep. And there is also fragmentation of sleep. That means the sleep breaks at about 1 a.m. and he's not able to go back to sleep for almost 2 to 3 hours. As a result, the next question is, what happens in the day? So the day he's tired, he's not able to focus, he's not able to concentrate. We need to know something more about the personal history. So he is living alone and in a hostel at present and studying for the entrance exams for which he is taking online coaching these days. To go further, we need to understand the day and night complete 24/7 activity that we call it. He said that he goes to bed some days of the week at 10 p.m. and some days 1 a.m. and sleep occasionally comes in 30 minutes and sometimes it takes a few hours. The wake up time varies and some days he's out of bed at 10 or 11 a.m. but some days at maybe 3 p.m. He has online classes which go for about 4.5 hours starting from about 11 and they finish by 2 to 3 p.m. Post that he has some food, then he studies and that's the kind of day that he has. We need further answers to a few more questions. There's not much of caffeine intake. There is no alcohol intake. He's a non-smoker, no history of any substance. What about exercise? It's on for about 10 to 15 minutes when he wakes up. So he did meet some physicians and some people advised sedative hypnotic, the Z drug, which is a zolpidem. But he was reluctant to take this medicine and thus sought another opinion. So what is the possibility? The possibility, yes, is, or the impression is it's insomnia for a few months, yet has not crossed maybe the full term for chronic insomnia, but definitely insomnia. And the main factor seems to be a poor sleep hygiene and a poor coordination of the circadian body clock. Thus, his sleep timings are fluctuating, his wake up time is fluctuating, and that leads to a very bad day. So what would I suggest to this person? So first and foremost, we start by saying that we need to work on this together. Assure him that it will get well. We do not need any sedative hypnotics at this stage. But we definitely need him to fix a bedtime and fix a wake-up time. By doing that, he will set the body clock for the day and for the night. He also needs to be aware that if he is not sleepy or sleeping, then he needs to get out of bed. And the activity that is permitted at that time could be reading or listening to music, but staying away from screen time. And to increase his exercise, we do need at least 30 to 40 minutes for a young boy for the body to get tired. So thus, recommending these just simple measures and advice to fill a sleep diary for himself will go a long way to setting the body clock right and achieving a good night and a day. And hopefully we will avoid the use of any of the sedative hypnotics. Thank you.